The Philippines taking the lead in pushing for the advancement and implementation of the United Nations Women's Peace and Security Agenda. Over 70 member states reaffirmed their commitment to the declaration during a meeting chaired by the Philippines in Manila from October 28 to 30. The declaration is an important follow-through to a UN resolution calling for the prevention of gender-based violence during times of armed conflict. During the same event, the Philippines also secured over 2 billion pesos in foreign aid for women, peace, and security in the Bangsamoro. The funds will be used to address birth mortality, as well as feed children and help farmers in the region. The reported death toll from severe tropical storm Christine and Typhoon Leon climbs to 145. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council says it has already validated 14 deaths. Over 2 million families, or nearly 8 million individuals, were affected by Christine and Leon. Damage to agriculture is at 4.43 billion pesos, while infrastructure damage was at 6.82 billion pesos. Now, the Social Welfare Department says they have distributed nearly 900,000 food packs across the country as of Thursday evening.
We were able to enter into relief proposition ng agreements with various local government units. Nagamit po nila natin yung kanila po mga warehouses at nakapagpadala nga doon ng mga stockpiles natin. At gayon din po, meron tayong mga existing framework agreements with private manufacturers na kung saan na-complement nila yung sinasagwa natin na production ng mga food packs dito sa ating major hubs.
Meanwhile, the country's Electrification Administration says efforts are underway to restore power in places hit hardest by Christine and Leon. Administrator Antonio Almeida notes power is almost 100% restored in the Bicol region. Now, electrification efforts in Albay City are at 90%, while Batangas province is at 70% due to some accessibility issues. Almeida assures the public power restoration across the country should be complete in a couple of weeks.
Ang ating national government, ultimo ang ating presidente ay nakatutok po sa pagtulong at pag-agarang solusyon sa restoration ng kuryente sa mga lugar na yan.
Over 30.8 million pesos in cash for work wages have been distributed to workers of the Bicol region. The initial payouts were awarded to 7,249 workers who were impacted by severe tropical storm Christine. The Labor Department and employment officials distributed these wages through their program for displaced workers. The Tupad program gives temporary wage employment of community work to Filipinos affected by disaster and calamities. The AI wars continue among the world's tech giants. OpenAI has beefed up its ChatGPT generative AI chatbot with search engine capabilities as it takes on Google's dominance on web search. The upgrade enables users to receive fast and timely answers with links to relevant web sources. This allows ChatGPT to provide real-time information from across the web. Meanwhile, Google Maps and Waze getting an upgrade as well. The tech giants now applying generative AI with Gemini models to Google Maps with the help of Gemini. Google Maps can also come up with a summary of customer reviews of places to visit and even show answers to frequently asked questions about the spot. Google also said it is introducing new AI-driven changes to navigation map app Waze. Drivers using Waze will soon be able to tap on the reporting button in the app, then speak normally in English.